I'm Amy Cherry. This local news is a service of Flagler County's Toyota dealer, Beaver Toyota, here to wow ya. Help is on the way for hundreds in Flagler County who've been laid off. John Arking has the latest.
Following Monday's stunning news that the nearly 450 employees at the Flagler County Sea Ray plant would be laid off as early as the end of the week, efforts are underway to try and find new jobs for those workers. Jane Pfeiffer is the president and CEO of the Volusia Flagler Manufacturers Association.
We immediately sent over a list of 117 companies that are looking for employees. We have them posted on our job board on our website, www.vmaonline.com. And when they click on the company, it will show them how to click to get to the career board of each one of these companies. The manufacturers were calling all day yesterday because they need help. There is a skilled labor shortage out there, and people are ready to just grab as many people as they can.
Illinois-based Brunswick Corporation, which owns Sea Ray, had been trying to sell the company since December. When those efforts failed, the decision was made to discontinue Sea Ray's sports yacht and yacht models. From the WNZF Newsroom, I'm John Arking.
This portion of WNZF Local News, a service of the Daytona Beach International Airport. Fly to the Big Apple in a New York minute on JetBlue from the Daytona Beach International Airport.
Hurricane Matthew was the most powerful storm to hit Flagler County since 1893. The storm, a Category 3, put local emergency response systems to the test and left several without power for days, flooding whole neighborhoods and destroying beach dunes and parts of State Road A1A. A new report found that Flagler County did coordinate a large-scale response and recovery that involved several partnering agencies that responded quickly to citizens' needs. But the report also found the county needs to continue to enhance its communication processes and enhance its plans to prepare for larger, more devastating storms. The report included notations that meal planning and a lack of maps were issues at the County Emergency Operations Center. Steps to be taken include increasing disaster staffing and training and enhancing disaster resiliency among critical facilities. Bunnell is close to hiring a city manager. The City Commission voted to extend an offer to Martin Murphy in a vote 3-2. Mayor Kathleen Robinson and Vice Mayor John Rogers casted the no votes. Murphy, who served in several administrative jobs, including a city manager post in New York, has a master's in public administration, giving him an edge over candidates Scott Tipton, Alvin Jackson, and Lyndon Bonner, who actually already served as Bunnell's city manager from 2002 to 2006. No salary has been set yet, but the city's former city manager made just over $71,000 a year. An argument over Chinese food lands a Palm Coast man in jail. Rich Petschke explains.
Police say it happened last Saturday when George Virgin's girlfriend ordered Chinese takeout, and Virgin said it had cost too much. That resulted in Virgin hitting the victim in the face. As the victim was on the phone with the restaurant to go over the bill, Virgin came up to her and pointed a gun in her face. The gun went off as the victim tried to get the weapon away from her, with a bullet hitting her in the ear. Investigators say Virgin told them it was the victim who had the gun in her hand, threatening to shoot Virgin's son. Virgin was booked into the Flagler County Jail on $42,000 bond. From the WNZF Newsroom, I'm Rich Petschke.
And now you're up to date on Flagler's Morning News. I'm Amy Cherry.